going down to buy milk.
Taking you to basement.
Lift take me to fifth floor.
Taking you to fifth floor.
Sparsh. Sparsh means touch. But I'm talking about a different touch today. The apartment dwellers, the multi-story commercial building users, they have a unique problem these days. They want to use the lift, but they can't touch the lift buttons. We have an interesting solution for this problem. Bangalore-based home automation company Silvan Innovation Lab has a solution for this, and it's interestingly called Sparsh. We have Mr. Avinash K. Gautam, the CEO of Silvan Innovation Lab, to talk more about this innovation. Avinash, tell me more about Sparsh.
When we go to office or a hotel or an apartment complex, any of these public areas, we find is a lift. And a lot of people come in and touch the lift button. And that can be a source of viral infection because a lot of people are touching it and you don't know who's carrying what. So there is actually a need to make such things contactless. So Sparsh is our solution for making elevator solution contactless and elevator operation contactless. And we are doing it by three ways. One is using an app where you can go, scan a QR code on the lift, and using the app, you can actually operate the lift, call it down, call it up, or inside the lift car, you can specify which floor to go to. You are touching your phone, but not the lift buttons. Second way of operating the lift in a contactless manner is using voice. You can actually speak to the lift and instruct it to which floor to go to. And the third way of making the lift contactless, which we have done, is by using what we call as proximity sensors. So proximity sensors are sensors which detect if anything is coming close to it. And we create a panel which has these proximity sensors. And all you have to do to operate the lift, either for calling up or down when you are outside it or inside the car to take it to a particular floor or pause the door and so on and so forth, is take your finger to the panel but not touch it. And when you do that, the lift will operate for you. So using the app, using the voice, and using the proximity sensing technology, these are the three methods which we are providing to the customers, and customer can opt for whatever they choose.
Avinash, with the present slowdown in all sectors, and particularly in the real estate sector, home automation is one thing the end users will be thinking whether to go for it or not. There are a lot of job losses, and also many have had the pay cuts too. So paying their EMIs itself, it's difficult for them. So the home automation will be their last option. Where do you think this sector will grow in the next few months or few years? And do you think home automation will be impacted by all the slowdown?
It seems that most of us will just continue working from home even after all the restrictions are taken away, because you know, it's very apparent that for a lot of people and for a lot of companies, work from home actually does make sense. You don't have to spend time in the traffic, you're less tired, you're more relaxed, and you can spend more time at the work. So, you know, people have actually observed productivity improvements, and the work from home looks like is going to be the way of life. While we are working from home, what do you do? You are in front of your computer. You're glued to your computer, and still you have to handle a lot of things. If someone comes at the door, how do you open the door without getting up? How do you, you know, do various things in the house without getting up? So this work from home, I believe, will require a certain degree of support from the automation system for it to make it a more seamless experience. Of course, you can get by without it, but pre-COVID days, home automation was mostly to make your life more safe, secure, and comfortable. But now its relevance is more in terms of making your life, you know, more contactless, if you will, and making your work from home experience more seamless. So I believe, yeah, there are problems, but there are also new opportunities which any situation throws up, and companies like us just have to adapt ourselves and fine tune our technologies to suit the needs of the people. So that's what we're doing.
Silvan Innovation Labs is in the home automation sector for the last 12 years. And it's been funded by Samsung, Infuse Ventures, the Chennai Angels, and One Crowd. Recently, you partnered with Purvankara for their home automation called Bluenex Life. Just throw us more light on this product, Avinash.
It's a very innovative system. It's a very robust and reliable and easy to maintain system, and very easy to and intuitive to use system which we have created. And I believe this is going to be very, very valuable and received very well by the customers when they start using it. So that's what Bluenex is all about. The details of it can be seen from the Purvankara website. It is an elaborate specification which we have got. And you know, a lot of things around, like I said, the planning, network security, everything has been well thought through. And people just have to move into that project and start enjoying this automation system along with various other things.
What are your future projects and any new innovations in the pipeline? And tell me more about your new innovations, Avinash.
More than the home automation system, I would say the future of the homes are going to change with things like this. We are in the early days for sure. In India, if you look at it, hardly 0.001% of the people would have access to something like this. But through various builders who are actually now pre-fitting their projects with these kind of systems, thousands more are getting access to this, and thousands will become lakhs, and lakhs will become crores. And we see a future where this thing will become a part and parcel of your life, and people will come to expect it in any building they make. So that is on the home part. Our focus for next 6 months to 1 year will be, how do we repurpose and reprovision our IoT technology to help the businesses, various businesses and enterprises and the apartment complexes to get back to some kind of normalcy by, you know, ensuring a much more healthy work environment, ensuring that a lot of things can be done in as contactless manner as possible. And Spurs, which is our contactless elevator solution, is just the beginning, but we'll be coming up with many more things to come.
And thank you very much for speaking to Smart Sustain, Avinash, and I wish you all the best for your home automation, and wish the sector will improve and many people will start using home automation and also be tech savvy, and also a lot of interesting features are there, and also it's not about just the features, and it's also about energy efficiency, it's about being smart, isn't it? And thank you very much. Thanks for speaking to Smart Sustain, Avinash. Thank you.